All right, welcome back, everyone. We have a new ZBrush out, ZBrush 2018. I thought I'd go over real quickly on some quick tips that I've already kind of figured out for myself, and I want to share with you and kind of show you some quick workflows. And so this is just going to be a quick video for you. As you can see, I've already come up with a new UI and everything here. I always like to have everything exposed. I don't like digging through menus and stuff like that. If you want the UI, you can definitely go over to my Gumroad page and you can pick it up right there. It's free and a bunch of other goodies. Even I now have a new store on QBrush. I got a store over there, so you can get it either place. I'll have the links in the description below. So back to ZBrush here. Real quickly, real nice thing that Pixelogic finally did for us here. We now have a new save as startup material. You can actually click on any material you like. I've already done basic material and then click save startup. And now every time it opens, boom, it's the basic material, which is kind of cool. Thank you, Pixelogic. It's the little things that add to ZBrush. Let's see. Let's do something with kind of a common question that I've been seeing, and I was kind of curious myself. It has to do with the Sculptris Pro, which is a really cool addition. Right here, I got a basic sphere 3D. We'll make it a poly mesh, and let's do some drawing here. I'm going to turn on Sculptris mode, or Pro mode, or whatever, Sculptris, whatever. And we're going to go down to snake hook. And we're going to pull something out here. Does a great job. Let me show you what I'm trying to get to here. The one thing that differs between Sculptris and Dynamesh is they don't fuse the meshes together. But I found a quick workaround with another new addition to ZBrush. So say like I want to put these two tentacles together, make a little handle. All right, so I'm going to do move topological, and I'm going to try to move him over. Let me scale him up a little bit here. Angle him together. Now with Dynamesh, we'd be able to fuse it together, and then it would... it would re-dynamesh the whole topology, which I really don't want. So let me do a quick inflate here. Scale this down. Inflate these up just a little bit here. Doesn't have to be perfect. I just want to fuse those two things together. But right now, they're two separate basic islands of topology. So if you do click on W, that'll put us into the move mode, brings up the gizmo. Now we can select our gear icon there and go to remesh by union and then click it. It'll give you a quick preview of what's going on. You really can't see a whole lot. So go ahead and click the gear again, accept it. Okay, now go with Q. That'll bring us back into draw mode and up here. Now if we, let me scale him down a bit, hit shift, and there you go. It's fused together. Oops, went too far with the smooth in there. So quick and easy way to fuse your mesh together. Let's see, what do I want to go over with Sculptris Pro real quick? Say like you want to add some topology down here without going crazy, you can actually turn off, take your Z intensity all the way down, and then you click on it and you add topology down here without actually deforming the mesh. It's kind of hard to see, but it's there. So if I want to add some up here, some here, and then just smooth it out a little bit better. Turn that on. And of course, you can always just smooth it away, melt it away. And now we defeated the purpose of fusing them together. Control Z that. Let me show you another fusion experiment here, or union experiment here. If you do, let's go to B for brush. Let's do I insert. We're looking for insert primitives, nothing too fancy. I'm just going to do the cylinder, just insert cylinder. I'm going to insert that one there. Hit W real quick and we will sync him into the mesh. And go ahead and Q, clear a mask, and we can always just do our move to the, hit W again to pull up the move. We'll go to remesh by union, and there we go. Accept, it is now fused together. Okay, you kind of already knew that, right? So let's go ahead and draw. We'll go ahead and scale him down a little bit. We can smooth him into the mesh. It's a little wonky up there. Kind of watch every once in a while. Sometimes you tear the polys. You'll actually create little holes in there. So kind of keep an eye on that. Every once in a while, you got to do a close mesh function or close hole function, which can be found in geometry and modified topology. And here is your close holes. There it is. I got it on my UI. It's so much easier. I use it quite often. All right, so I got him all nice and neat. So let's do that one more time. Let's go back to BI and primitives again. This time we'll draw another one here, draw out a bigger one. W, we're gonna sync them in. Okay, Q, back to draw mode. Let me look at this real quick. Select him, isolate him. Now go to your polygroups and group as DynaMesh sub. That. And clear the mask, get a quick look at him. W, doop, hit that gear, remesh by union, and boom. And because we told it to be a DynaMesh sub, it treats it like a Boolean function. So it'll subtract. Pretty cool. All right, so gear, accept. And back to draw. Let me get back a regular standard here. We're going to smooth this guy out. Yeah, the Sculptris Pro is a really cool tool for concept art. You know, definitely would not be end result, definitely. But if all you're doing is just trying to get a good idea, you can scratch out ideas super fast with it. All right, so let's see. What else do I want to show you? I think I want to show you... I'm going to show you Polygroupit, which is under your Z plugins. And right here, I'm actually going to show you the Create Polygroups from... paint borderless. So take your, I'm going to fill this object real quick with color, fill them with white, and switch it over to black. And I am still on standard, but I want to go to RGB, turn off add, and I'm going to change the focal shift so I get a much harder brush so it's not so super soft. I'm going to show you a really cool way to create polygroups to help you with Z Remesh. So let's go ahead. I'm going to turn up lazy smooth here and turn the radius up here. Let's see how that works. That works out really good. And a cool thing with if you have Sculptress on and you're doing this with just RGB, if you pull up the polyframes, it added a whole bunch of polygons there to support that that paint, which is quite handy. So say like we want to get this little arm here and we want to have a polygroup for that. Let me see if I could do that a little better. come around. And let's do the same thing with these guys real quick. I'm going to do a quick Control W, make sure everything's under the same polygroup. Though the polygroupit will delete any existing. Whoops, what happened there? All right, let's do this. Okay, do one for him. I know, that's super accurate. Sorry, guys. This is just for demo purposes. As you can see, some of the polygrouping down there, or the mesh, looks like it's tearing a little bit. And that seems to happen quite a bit, at least when I've been playing with the Sculptris Pro. So we'll just go ahead and do a quick close hole. Where's that bugger at? There he is. Yeah, I guess that closed up a bunch in there. Boy, there's some really weird stuff down there. Let me go see if I can smooth some of that out. Oops. See if that'll fix some of that. Yeah. All right. All right, let's go back to our original thing here. Let me check switch color, RGB. Ah, looks like I tried to paint down there. I want to get rid of those. All right, now go to your plugin. We'll do Polygroupit by Paint Borderless. Do that, wait for it real fast. It's usually a real quick process. And if we turn on Polyframe, and there we go. Now we got our individual pieces marked out. So we can go ahead and I'm just gonna fill the color back to white, which is under your color, fill object. There we go. Now it's back to white. Now go to your Z remesher. I know there's a deformer for it, but there's not enough controls in there. I don't really like it just yet. So I'm going to go up to target poly count 10 because you still have to come over here and click on keep groups. The only option it gives you is target polygons. It doesn't show you adaptive, anything. It doesn't give you all these fine-tuned controls. I mean, let me show you. W, boom, and you go to remesh by Z remesher, and it's all it's got is symmetry controls and poly count controls. No, sorry. And let's delete frame, back to draw, and we'll just set up everything here in Z remesh, see how it does here. I have run into some issues with Sculptress Pro and Z remeshing. It does hiccup sometimes. It'll either not do the function, crash ZBrush. Yeah, I think it's just with all the tessellation and decimation and whatever you want to call it. And there we go. Not too bad. It's a little goofy here in some of these parts here. So what we could do, deformation, polish by groups. That'll help it out a little bit. Still a little wonky. Oh, let's turn Sculptress off. Smooth. Made that weird little pop mark there. Polish my groups again and go back to geometry, and we'll do half Z remesh. There we go. Got it back down to the 5,000 initially there, and that's not bad. But yeah, that is just a quick tips there for you there. I hope you got something out of that. Just some quick thoughts that I had that I thought I'd share with you. Let me know what you want in the comments. If there's something specific you really need me to go over, I know there's a lot more options I will be going over with. Do have another tutorial plan that uses a lot of these steps. That'll use the deformers, which I can go over with in detail in that tutorial. So, but yeah, like I said, I hope you learned something today. We will talk at you later. You guys have a great day.